Welcome my dear student. Today I am going to start the chapter Computer Networks. What do you mean by network? Basically, we talk network in the sense of the computer, but is usually if we see in our daily life, our friends or a group of friends are also known as network. Your relationship with other people can also be considered as network. So before starting with the computer, let's try to understand in simple words that when more than one device is connected to another in order to exchange or share some data, then this type of configuration is called the network. And in wide sense, we can say the interconnection of the computers are known as the networking. So this is the simple definition through which you can explain the term networking, that if you are connecting more than one system with each other and they can transfer data from one system to another, then this type of network is called as the computer network, as you can see in the diagram. In this particular diagram, you can see a computer is connected with other laptops, other systems, a printing machine, a scanner device. So these type of devices, when you are connecting with each other, then this is known as network. If I want to simplify it more, then you can see in your computer lab that you can see there are many systems together, they are connected with each other, but the printer or a scanner are less than quantity as compared with the computer. But if you want to print any document, any data, you can give the instruction from any one of the computer and you can have your printout from that printer only. So this can be done with the help of the networking, as the computers are connected through the wires and in this way they are exchanging the data with each other. So this is the computer network in simple words. Now moving forward, that why we need computer network or what are the advantages of computer network. So first of all, as I had given the example that you can share your data with your printer, with your scanner. So here what we are doing, we are sharing the hardware. We have a single hardware, we have a single printer, but more than one device can be attached to this printer. So in this way we are sharing the hardware. In the similar way, we can share the software also, and the main software is installed on the server system and the client server system are accessing them. So as when you are playing any network based game like Free Fire, like PUBG or any other game in which online connection is required, so actually you are not playing the game on your own device, you are playing the game and your data is stored on the server also. So this type of gaming technique is also known as the software sharing, when we are talking in the term of software sharing. The next example that what we have is the fast and effective communication. So as we can share information easily from one system to another system, then obviously we can communicate in a faster way in a non-network zone. For example, if the printer is connected with a single device, then what we have to do, we have to take the data in any pen drive and then we came to that particular system, attach the pen drive, copy the data, and then we are only able to take the printout. So it is a time taking process. The next is security. So with the help of the networking, you can also provide security to your offices, to your workplaces, to your house department, because in the network area you can implement the firewall technique, the encryption technique, the password technique, through which your system and data is secured on that particular system. Now reducing redundancy means when a data is stored at a single place, so there is no more copies will be some other system. There is a server on that particular system, every data is stored, and there is no any other copy on other data, so there is no any type of confusion is there. If there is single data, then that particular data be authentic to all the users, and in the similar way it is reducing the redundancy. As we are sharing the software and hardware, so we can say that we are saving the time and cost. It is very simple, and efficiency means the deletion, modification, collection of the data, sharing of the data, sharing of the software, sharing of the hardware can be done efficiently. So these are the few advantages of the computer network. So now moving ahead, our next topic is network component. So what is network component, or you can say what type of net components can be used when we are creating a network. So there are few components that can be used when you are creating a network, like switch, router, hub, there may be a client, a server, some wire. So we will discuss it one by one as the topic will be there. Now the first topic that what I am going to discuss is server. So as you all know, the server is a powerful computer that have all the access rights, all the data is stored. If there is any software sharing, then the software is also stored on that particular server. So server is a powerful computer. You can see in a simple way, a computer having more functionality, more storage capacity, more processing capacity than that particular system is called the server. As we all work, like we are uploading our data on CBSC sites, then we usually used to say server slow hai. Then it means that we are working on any remote location area system on which every data is stored. So this is what server. Now the next topic is client. So what is client? Any system that are accessing the data from the server is known as the client. As we are working or we are searching our data on Amazon and the Flipkart, so the system where all the data about the Amazon and Flipkart is stored is called as the server, and we are accessing those sites from our computers or laptops or through our mobiles, then these devices are known as the clients. Next is network interface card. So when you are connecting a computer in a network, then there is a type of address should be assigned to all the system. In order to communicate with one and other, you need some sort of address. Telephonically, you need phone number, message, you need the WhatsApp number. If you are sending letter, then you should know the address. Similarly, when we are communicating with the computers, then there should be some sort of address. And network interface card is used to provide those addresses to the system. So this is a card that is attached with your CPU, and with the help of this card, you are able to connect one system to another system. There are mainly two types of network interfaces cards are available. The first is wired and the second is wireless NIC. Now moving forward, now media of connection means how you can connect our computer system. So we are connecting our computer system through the wires. As we all know, when we simply saw a wire, we could say it wire, but there are variety of wires available, and we can discuss it one by one. The very first wire that what is going to discuss, that is Ethernet twisted pair. This is common twisted pair cable that what we can easily see at our homes, two wires twisted with each other. So this type of twisted pair cables that what you can use in our local area networks, and with the help of the twisted pair cable, the speed of the network can also be increased. The next is coaxial cable. So when we need to send data at high speed, means when we want to increase the speed of the communication, then we are using the coaxial cable. And you can see this cable at your home through your dish antenna to your setup box. A black hard wire is connected एंड दिस ब्लैक हार्ड वायर इज नोन एज द कोएक्सियल केबल. द नेक्स्ट ऑप्टिकल फाइबर. सो वी आर यूजिंग ऑप्टिक फाइबर्स व्हेन वी हैव टू सेंड डेटा थ्रू द लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस एंड वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू अटेन्यूएट आर डेटा. देन व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग द फाइबर ऑप्टिक्स. एंड सम ऑफ यू हैव सीन ऑरेंज कलर ऑफ वायर नियर द रोड. सो दीज वर द फाइबर ऑप्टिक्स केबल दैट आर undergrounded and these type of cable are used to send the data at very high speed. And the main speciality of this type of cable connection is that the data can be travel more distance without getting low. So this is fiber optics. Now the next device is switches and router. So switches and routers are working as the connection or a connector between more than one networks. We are using switch and routers in order to connect our system. And the routers are used to select a path, a correct path, a less traffic path when we are sending data from the sender to receiver. The next is modem. So modem is the acronym of the modulator and the demodulator. So it commonly turns the digital signal to the analog signal and the analog signal to the digital signal. So that's are the component of the network. The next topic is types of network. So the types of network depend upon the size of the network and the total number of computer system that what we are using in the network. According to the number of the system, the area of the network, there are various type of computer networks available. As I think that you all aware about the computer network. So the first network is PAN. That is personal area network, and broadly it is known as the body area network also. Means a network that which is around us 10 meters, or you can say nowadays we all have a Wi-Fi connection at our homes and every device is connected to that particular Wi-Fi. So this is also a sort of network. We are sharing the same network on every mobile, on every laptop. So this type of network is called as personal area network. The term personal identify that the network is confined to a family, to a building, you can say. So according to their range, it is about 10 meters range. Means you can simply say that when you are sharing your data with the help of the Bluetooth or with the help of the share it as we used to do. So these type of data sharing is also called as the personal area network. And simply if you are listening the song by using your headphone, then there is also a sort of network. So some are using Bluetooth earplugs and some are using simple wired earplug. So according to this discrimination, there may be two types of personal area network. The one is wired area network and the second one is wireless area network. The next is LAN or LAN. So LAN is the most commonly used term nowadays. So this is the local area network. You all are aware about it. So when we are trying to connect departments of a particular office in a particular campus, then there we need the local area network, and the range of this network is almost 10 kilometers. So within 10 kilometers when we are constructing any type of network, then we are using LAN over there. So LAN can be also wired or wireless depending upon the situation, depending upon the devices that what we are using. So this is LAN. The next is MAN. MAN is Metropolitan Area Network, and the Metropolitan Area Networks covers the whole city. For example, you can understand it like a bank having more than one branches in a city, and the banks wants to connect with each other and communicate with each other. And you can take the example of the ATM also. When we are drawing the money from the ATM, then what is happened, our database that is located to the server is get updated. So all these can be done with the help of the metropolitan area network. Means when we are trying to connect or trying to communicate with such two devices that are located in a city, and communication is there, So this type of network is called the metropolitan area network. Now the next is wide area network. So I think you are all aware about it, the internet, that what we are using, the through we are communicating, the through which you are seeing the video right now. So this type of network is called the wide area network. The widest network we have is internet. Now the next topic we have is the network topology. So first of all, you should know that what is topology. So topology is simply how we are connecting or how we are organizing the computers with each other, and in which way or sequence we are transferring the data from one computer to another computer. All these topics come under the topic, that is network topology. So the first topology that what I am going to discuss, that is bus topology. In a bus topology, there is a common wire, and as you can see in the figure, that is this. In this figure you can see a common wire is going through this, and all the computers are connected with this common wire. So this type of topology is called as the network topology. This is bus topology. This topology is the cheapest topology, and the data communication is reliable in this topology. But if the backbone of the network get broken, then what will happen? The whole communication will get stopped. This is the only problem with the bus topology. And the extension of the network is easier in bus topology related with other topologies also. Hope you are understanding the topic. The next is a ring topology. As its name implies, ring topology. So when we are arranging the computer in such a form that they are almost preparing a ring type structure, as you can see in the figure. So this type of topology is called as the ring topology. In this topology, every system is connected with two other systems on both sides, and the data can be sent from one system to directly two systems. The next topology we have, the star topology. As you can see in the figure, that is a star topology. It is the form of the star. In the star topology, the hub or the server is situated in the middle position, and other computers are connected with each other. So in this particular system, when you are trying to send the data from one computer to another computer, then what will happen? The data is first sent to the server, and then server passes the data to the system for which the data is sent. So this is about the topology. In a simple sentences, topology is a geometrical, or you can say the how we are arranging the computers. So this is called the topology. Now the next topic, that what is network architecture. So what is architecture? Architecture means that how the computers are communicating with each other, then this is called the network architecture. So we have simply two type of architecture. The first one is client server architecture, and the second is peer to peer architecture. Now try to understand the difference between these two architectures. Now consider a class with a teacher and without a teacher. So with a teacher, a class is client server architecture, and without a teacher, when only the students are there, then this is peer to peer architecture. Now how? Try to understand that I had told you earlier that server is a powerful machine having all the capability, having all the processing capability, storage capability, and some other capabilities also. Means and what are the clients? Clients are the simple system that are trying to access that particular server. Now consider a sequence, a subject teacher in your class teaching you at a particular time that what you are doing, you are trying to access the database of the teacher. the knowledge capacity of the teacher, the processing ability of the teacher. So in a class sequence, if there are 30 students and one teacher, then teacher is powerful than the student in the term of the knowledge, in the term of the processing capabilities. And what the students are doing, students are trying to access the data from the teacher. So this type of scenario is called the client server architecture. So in the client server architecture, you are simply say there is a one powerful computer and many other clients are there, and all the clients are trying to access the data from that powerful computer, and this type of arrangement is called the client server architecture. And now coming to the next architecture, that is peer-to-peer architecture. So as I told you, that consider a class without the teacher. Now there are 30 or 35 students. Every student having the same mental capability, having the same processing capability, having the same storage capability. So now they are all at same level. They are all doing their work individually. They don't depend upon each other for any type of work. But in the case of some data loss or some data requirement, what you do sometimes, if you are not able to attend the class, then you ask for the work with your friend in the simple way. When the system are asking for the data to another computer, then this type of architecture are called the peer-to-peer architecture. Now in the computer sense, you can simply say it, when all the processing system at the same level, having the same capabilities, and they are simply sharing the data in order to help each other or in order to complete their work, then this type of architecture is known as the peer-to-peer architecture. Now here you will see that how you can access file from the shared drive. Means you are simply sitting on a particular system in your own cabin and you want to access the data from some other department, from some other cabin. Now how you can see it? In the step one, first go to the desktop and there is a network icon there. Click on it. In the network icon, you will have, after clicking on it, you will have a view pane. And here all the computers that are linked on a network will easily displayed, and the name of the computer system also. So from which computer you want to collect the data, just double click on that particular computer. And after double clicking on the computer, you will have all the shared folders, shared drives also. And according to the need, click on the folder and click on the copy. And what you want to do, you can copy the data, you can use the data, you can take the printout. So what you can do in a shared network. So this is the proper way through which you can share your data. Now the last topic is network security. So this topic is discussed already, that in the network system you can use login ID password so that no other can access your system. Only the authorized user, that who has all the login ID and password, can only access the particular system, and the loss of data may be prevented. And the next is access level. So you can try to understand, like you all are aware about the computer system, and there are two types of login. You can easily see the first one is the admin login and second one is the guest login. So when you enter the computer in the admin login, you will have some different type of access rights, and when you are logging in with the guest login, then you may not have such access rights. So just by sharing the access level or by dividing the access level, you can implement the network security in your system. So hope this session may be useful to you all, and see you next time in my next video. Thank you.